Hello friends, I hope it's a good day for everyone. This is Vineet. Welcome to my YouTube channel Techies Hub. So this session is all about covering the course outline and the learning objective of Certified Scrum Master CSM. So today we could see now a trend of people taking so many certifications on CSM, CSPO, etc. So CSM is a certification which is offered by the organization Scrum Alliance. Scrum Alliance makes sure that the people appearing for the CSM exam also takes a 2-day training of the Scrum from a CST. CST stands for Certified Scrum Trainer. So I will be giving a walkthrough of the learning and the topics that gets covered when you attend a CSM course. So the Scrum Alliance is not forcing the people just to learn, just to attend the 2-day training in order to apply for the exam. They want to make sure that everyone understands the Scrum framework in the right way before applying for the exam. So once after you attend the Certified Scrum Master training, it changes your understanding towards the Scrum. So most of you will be following Scrum in your project, but are you sure you are following the correct Scrum framework? Or do you know how much customization you have been brought into the project? So what the Scrum Alliance is trying to tell you is like, don't put anything into the Scrum framework. You can only put anything on top of the Scrum framework. For example, consider that a daily Scrum meeting is taking 50 minutes in your project. So that is exactly what the Scrum framework is intended to do. But if in your organization, if you feel that it is taking more than 15 minutes and the organization says that it is okay, then you are not doing a correct Scrum framework in your project. So once you attend this Certified Scrum Master training, you will completely understand what is a Scrum framework and how you should follow the Scrum framework. And once you understand it, you can always put your customization on top of it, but not break the existing Scrum framework. So let's not waste any more time. Let's jump into the session. So I'll be walking through the agenda. So it will be all about Agile and Scrum. What is Agile facilitation? Agile coaching? How the Scrum Masters provide services to the development team, to the product owner, and to the organization? And just an info, all the information mentioned in the presentation are copyrights of Scrum Alliance, and I am just using it for the learning purpose only. So let's talk a brief on CSM. So a Certified Scrum Master is an individual who has been taught by a Certified Scrum Trainer about the Scrum terminology, practices, and principle. So CSM course is a first step on the path to becoming more agile. Once you familiarize with the team roles, events, and artifacts, it will help to extend your career, help to improve the foundations of the Scrum, and it will help you to demonstrate your attainment of core Scrum knowledge, and also it will help you to engage with Agile practitioners. So that's all about Scrum. So moving on to the topics that we cover in the Scrum. So one of the topics is Agile and Scrum. So what is an Agile? Is it a mindset or a methodology? And how it differs from a framework? So is Scrum a framework? So how a framework is different from the mindset or the methodology? Then they will be talking about Agile Manifesto. So how the Scrum came into picture? So what is the backbone of Scrum? So what are the four values that they talk in the Agile Manifesto? So the CST will be explaining the four values in detail, along with the 12 principles that we have in Agile Manifesto. So the Scrum follows these four values and the 12 principles. Then we will be moving on to the Scrum theory. So the first one is, Scrum is based on empirical process. So what is this empirical process? And what are the defined processes? What are the three pillars in Scrum theory? So those are all the things that we'll be covering under empirical and defined process. Then we will be talking about what are the 5 Scrum values and examples of some Scrum practices based on these Scrum values. Then what are the applicability of Scrum? So if you want to get some good results in which all areas the Scrum should be used and which all areas the Scrum should not be. And then moving on to the Scrum roles. So what are the roles that we have in Scrum? So there are roles like Scrum Master, Product Owner, and the Development Team. And the CSD will be talking about Scrum Master, some of the prerogatives, some of the responsibilities, some of the things that he should not do, and what is the authority, and what are the functions of each of these members, and how they help each other, how they help in different meetings, and all those things. And that will be covering in the first day of the two-day training. Along with that, they will be talking about sprint and increment. Why? The sprint is iterative and incremental. So what will change if the sprint is not iterative and incremental? And why the sprint should be protected, and what in sprint should be protected, and why it is a time boxed? What will happen if we have shorter and longer duration sprints? Also, what are the negative consequences that arise when the development team consists of fewer than 3 or more than 9 people? Then moving on to the Scrum meetings. So what are the Scrum meetings that we have? So the first one is the sprint planning meeting. So this talks about who all are the participants, what are the responsibilities of the Scrum team, what are the activities that they have, what is the sprint goal, and what are the benefits of sprint goal, and what are the negative impacts that arise if the Scrum team disregards one of the element of the sprint planning. Then moving on to the daily Scrum meeting. So similarly, who are all the participants? Then how it differs from a traditional status meeting? Then what are some of the responsibilities of the dev team? And what are the questions that we ask in daily Scrum agenda? And what are some of the negative impacts if we didn't follow some of the elements of the daily Scrum meeting? Then we have the sprint review meeting. So it also talks about who are the participants, what are the review activities, and what are the outcomes, and what are the things that you should not talk in the sprint review, who is the primary speaker of the sprint review, and what are some of the negative impacts. Then moving on to sprint retrospective meeting. So this also talks about who are the participants of the retrospective, and some of the responsibilities of the Scrum team, and some of the negative impacts that arise when the Scrum team disregards one or more of the elements of the sprint retrospective. And finally, we have the release planning meeting. So in the release planning meeting, we will be discussing who are the participants, what are the topics to be covered, and how much time it should take, and when the product should be released, all those details. Then we will be moving on to the Scrum artifacts. The first one is the product backlog. So what are the responsibilities of the dev team towards the product backlog? And what are the characteristics of the product backlog item? And what are the elements of product backlog item? Then moving to the product increment. When we should get a product increment? What is the product backlog refinement? How it affects the product increment? All those things. Then we will be talking about sprint backlog. What are the essential characteristics of a sprint backlog? How a sprint backlog can be changed, and how responsibility of making changes are divided among the team members. That's all about the Scrum artifacts. Then we will be moving on to something called definition of a done. So it talks when multiple teams are working on a same product backlog, why we need a shared and consistent definition of done, and why the definition of done evolves over time, and identify at least some places in Scrum where the Scrum team might note weakness in the definition of done, and what is the importance of a strong definition of done, and how Scrum Master facilitates one way to create the definition of done. Then after that, we will be talking about agile coaching. So what are the differences between facilitating, teaching, mentoring, and coaching, and how Scrum Master makes sure that he is a facilitator, he is a teacher, he is a mentor, and he is a coach, and what are some of the challenges facing a self-organizing team. Then how Scrum Master provides services to dev team. Who is called as a servant leader? What is servant leadership? And some scenarios where Scrum Master act as a servant leader for the Scrum team. And then how Scrum Master provides value towards engineering practices. So it talks about the technical depths and impact of accumulating technical depths. And what are some of the practices that we follow to make sure that the Scrum is going smoothly? Then how can the Scrum Master provide services to product owner? How Scrum Master coaches the PO, and what are some of the effective collaboration techniques that a PO can use to work with Scrum team, and some of the negative impacts? And then the final two points include how Scrum Master provides the services to organization in to remove the impediments, and also how the Scrum Master can coach the organization. So these are some of the topics that gets covered in the Scrum Master, and we have something called the burn down charts. So it talks about how we can create a burn down chart, who owns the sprint burn down chart, who creates the release burn down chart, and all those things. Then the last topic, which is an optional topic, it's about the scaling Scrum. What should we do when we work with multiple Scrum teams, and how we can work with a distributed Scrum team also. So these are the topics that gets covered when you attend a 2-day certified Scrum Master training. So thank you for being with me in this session, and have a good day. Bye.